All right, what I'm going to do here today is show you how to angle the build plate by 90 degrees to let your prints drip dry. Sure, you could print a 45 degree holder, and I highly recommend those. Those are amazing, but I haven't hooked up my FDM printer yet, and those are better done with FDM than this. First, I'm going to move my vat gently and carefully. Also, if you have a screen protector, this is a perfectly normal noise. That is totally normal. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to scoot it over far enough to catch the drips from this once I turned it. Be careful, don't spill your resin. What I like to do is move it quickly, turn it, and look at all drip. Make sure it's completely over the vat. Now, get in, oh, there we go. Okay. And as you can see, it's all dripping down into the vat now. In fact, let's lower this some. I did have one drip that was close. I can clean that up with some IPA and a paper towel. Don't rub your FEP with a paper towel, but you can clean everything else with a paper towel. But now you can let this sit here with no adapters, no printed parts. Just turn it 90 degrees. Make sure your vat is out far enough to catch any drips from any of the other pieces. So it needs to be out as tall as your tallest print is how far your vat needs to be out. Don't go over the midway point or it'll probably tip over and you'll spill all your resin. You can tell the midway point by the max that's printed there. So keep it well before the midway point. And, you know, be careful. This is your responsibility. But that's all there is to it. Unscrew your vat, move it over far enough to catch everything. If your print is too tall, this method may not work. But this is a pretty tall print, and all I had to do was just move this over a bit, and it's catching all the drips from the resin. After I've let this drip for a while, I usually go ahead and unscrew this, move the vat over here, and turn it the other direction, and let it drip from that direction. And after it's done that for, I don't know, half an hour to an hour on each side, then it's good to go, ready to start washing and cleaning. But if you let it drip before you wash it, you're going to save your isopropyl alcohol, your IPA, a lot of wear and tear. So you can use it a lot longer and it'll be less dirty. And here we are on the other side. I'm dripping it out. So, thanks for joining me. Here you go. Finito, completo.